Hey there, bootstrappers. This is Ryan Nickel coming at you with another day in the life of a bootstrap real estate investor. So what is agency? This is episode number 110 coming at you. So agency is something that gets violated all the time. And I'm not talking about agency, whereas you are a designated agent on behalf of a buyer or a seller, like as a real estate agent, licensed agent. That's not what I'm talking about. And I'm not talking about you're the designated agent for an LPOA. And for those of you that don't know what an LPOA is, it's a limited power of attorney. So I'm not talking about that kind of an agent. I'm talking about agency where you allow the person the right to choose. You're giving them the option to choose. And I've violated this a lot of times. I have, and I see it violated all the time as well. It's where you use different kinds of tactics, bully tactics, manipulation tactics, any way you can to get someone to do what you want them to do. What's up, Andre? And in doing so, you violate their agency. They don't have the right to choose because now they're being forced into that decision. And that's the worst type of business relationship you actually want to be in. If you have tenants in your properties, if you have people that are buying from you and that are selling from you, you want them to choose you of their own free will. They want to choose you because you are the best option. You don't want to force them or coerce them or bully them or browbeat them to do whatever they can to work with you. Now, I've done this and it's always backfired. When I've stooped low enough to do this, it has backfired. And I'm seeing it right now. I had a seller contact me and he's like, hey, you know what? I want to move forward with you. I have this contract with this company that's been doing this short sell. I'm like, great. Thanks for calling me up. I'd love to work with you. Go ahead and contact this company and go ahead and have them relinquish you from that contract. You might have to pay a cancellation fee. You know, sometimes they have that and that's just part of the business. Anyway, so this company has been sitting on his file because I approached this guy back in April and here we are end of July here. And I contacted him and I said back in April, like, hey, I'd love to buy this house. He's like, okay, great. For whatever reason, he chose to go a different direction. And I've stayed in contact with him. And finally today, he called me back and he says, hey, you know what? Let's move forward. What do I need to do? I said, well, currently you have an agreement or a contract with this company that's doing this short sale. So go ahead and get it, you know, reduced or you know, whatever you want, technical term is cancel, whatever, cancellation agreement. And he's like, I'll do that. So he went and he attempted to do that. And the lady goes, oh, I'm sorry. We're going to charge you a $5,000 processing fee. I'm like, $5,000 processing fee? Are you kidding me? I'm like, I asked him, I said, is this a law firm? He's like, no, it's not a law firm. I'm like, did you pay the money up front? No, I didn't. So you had no retainer on file with them? No, I didn't. Okay, so then what is it? He goes, it's just a contract that they're going to sell my house. Have they done anything? Have they performed? No, they haven't. Has the house been shown at all? He's like, not to my knowledge. He lives across the street, mind you. So none of this has happened. I said, okay, go ahead and get the cancellation. So she then returned back and she said to the guy, she's like, if you cancel this agreement, I'm going to come after you with a judgment of $5,000 because I want to get paid $5,000. And I'm like, this is total BS. This is a bully tactic. This is a scare tactic. One, I don't think it's going to hold up in any court. I haven't seen the contract yet, but you know, it's going to be pretty difficult to find that the guy changed his mind, that the services weren't being rendered, he canceled the contract, that they can charge $5,000 as a processing fee. That's a bit excessive. Anyway, so I'm just on this little rant because the whole time that I'm talking to this guy, I'm like, man, they are totally violating his agency here. I mean, he does not have the right to choose. He can't freely choose who he wants to work with now. He's now being obligated or forced and steered into this direction because he's afraid that they're going to sue him for $5,000. I said, look, man, if they're going to sue you, you have no other assets. What are they going to do? Are they going to attach a lien, a $5,000 lien to the house that I'm going to, because he's going to deed it over to me, that you're going to deed over to me that we're going to defend the foreclosure on? I'm like, let them do it. Chances are I'm going to lose the foreclosure anyway, but I'm going to attempt to fight it. And that's my whole goal, is to fight it. You know, if I win, great. If I don't, no big deal. But if I lose, they lost as well. Well, they can't. Are they going to serve you perfectly, you know, privately as a judgment, you know, a civil judgment? So anyway, it's so jacked up, and it has allowed me to see myself in this situation because I'm like, you know what? I've done that before. I've been a bully to tenants that don't pay their rent. I like tell them, you know, I threaten them that I'm going to kick them out and all of this stuff. And then it's like, you know what? I need to freely play this game and allow them to say, you know what? This is the choice that you have. I'm not going to force you into this choice, but this is the choice. You can choose to stay, you can choose to pay. In this particular case, this guy can choose to stay with this company, or he can cancel this contract and he can, you know, move forward. But they're trying to tell him that they will not cancel it unless he signs something that allows them to go ahead and file a judgment against him for $5,000. I'm like, that's total BS. Total BS. So anyway, agency, respect it. When you do, you won't have any problems, because now people have chosen you because you are the one best logical choice for them, and they have chosen you out of their own free will. No force, no coercion, no manipulation. That's all I got for you. Ryan Nickel, just remember, you're one deal away from changing your entire financial future for the better.